Hi everyone, I thought it would be good to share with you a roadmap of what to expect in SMU Law. This is going to be a very brief overview of the key milestones that you should take note of that I kind of didn't really know when I was in year one, so I was just going through sem by sem without actually knowing what I'm doing. It's good to at least have a rough idea so that you can better plan the mods you choose, your schedule, and or just basically set your expectations right. Your sem usually begins in August and your journey begins. The days of sleepless night starts from your first day of law school. Just kidding. Okay, let me explain my timeline. So each box here basically is the end of the sem. For instance, if I put year 1 sem 1, it just means end of year 1 sem 1. This is end of year 1 sem 2, year 2 sem 1, and year 2 sem 2. So for the first 2 years, from year 1 sem 1 to all the way to year 2 sem 2, you are doing mainly core law modules, which means that these are modules that everyone has to take. These modules are not optional. Examples of such modules include contract law, tort law, company law. Basically, they are so fundamental that every lawyer has to know all these laws. And so you are kind of forced to take these modules from year 1 to year 2. And then what happens after year 2 is you get to make a choice. So you get to take some electives, which means that you can take certain law modules that are a bit more specialized and a bit more narrow in scope. Like say, for example, if you're interested in competition law, then you can do a competition law module. Or if you're interested in IP, then you can do an intellectual property law module. If you are interested in perhaps being a divorce lawyer, then it is at this point where you try to take modules such as family law. Or if you are particularly interested in financial services regulation, for instance, it is also at this point where you try to take an FSR mod. Essentially, core modules, you have no option, and electives, you have an option. People will try to usually take the mods that will be useful for them at work. Also, if you are considering being perhaps the 10 distinctions person at Part B, you can also consider taking civil litigation so that you get a head start, but it's really up to you. There are some modules that will repeat in Part B, and if you are aiming to do well for Part B, you can try and take those modules here as well. But as for me, I didn't exactly take any module that was relevant for Part B. I just did the modules that I felt could potentially interest me instead of taking the modules that would help me score well in Part B. My 2 cents worth is to prioritize knowledge over scoring well, especially if you already know where you want to go into in future. You should definitely do the mod, even if you think that it's quite hard or you may not do well in it, because knowledge really helps in your work. To add on to why you should do the modules that are useful instead of easy to score here, it's also because, if you note here, look, you are applying for your TC at this point. So, by the time you do your electives, your grades, assuming that you have gotten a TC, shouldn't really matter that much anymore. Because your TC would have been offered to you based on the grades that you have accumulated all the way here to year 2, sem 2. So this was another point that I wanted to bring up, which try to make sure that your grades are at least decent all the way to before you apply for a TC. That's all for this portion. Now we look at here, internship is another important thing if you're studying SMU law because it is a graduation requirement. Usually people do it here, year 2, sem 2, April to August, the longer holiday between the two holidays that you get in a year. Yes, people try to do an internship here because this is before you get your TC. And if you're aiming to go for a medium-sized or small-sized firm, this internship may even determine whether you get a TC eventually. There are people who do try and apply for internships during these periods. It just depends on how driven you are and how else you are planning your schedule. There is also this other requirement in SMU, which is community service. People will tend to fit their community service in all the other holidays before the internship requirement needs to be met. And if you are going for an overseas community service project, you will tend to choose either the long one here or this one. Because here, maybe you are still fresh and adapting to school, you may not even have capacity to apply for an OCSP. Alternatively, you don't want to do an OCSP, you can do regular community service throughout the sem. But that will definitely be quite taxing, especially if you're trying to manage your readings, your project work, and all the other commitments that law school imposes on you. Now, remember to apply for your TC here. Usually for the big firms, they will state their opening date and just put your application in as soon as possible. And don't be disheartened if you don't get it here. I had a friend who actually did an internship here and managed to get the Clifford chance. So I put here exchange, because typically, once people get settled with their TC, they can go for exchange in peace, year 3, sem 1. But if you haven't gotten a TC by here, some people do an internship here, some people try to stay in Singapore so that they can do an internship here before going for exchange in year 4 sem 1. Just note that you can't really go on exchange on the last sem, year 4 sem 2, because it takes a while for the university overseas to process your results. And just by the school's policy, it will be too slow such that you can't graduate in time if you go for your exchange on year 4 sem 2. Another factor to consider whether to go in year 3 sem 2 or year 4 sem 1 is also the modules that you want to take. Because some mods are only offered in semester 1 and not in semester 2 and vice versa. So if you want to take a mod that's only offered in semester 1 in Singapore, then you may want to go in year 3 sem 2. But if you want to take a mod in sem 2, then you may go in year 4 sem 1. So it really depends on the mods you want to take and also whether you have gotten a TC. having said that, there are also some people who didn't manage to get TC and still go on exchange because now we are very interconnected and TC interviews can even be conducted online. It's not necessary for you to always be in Singapore. You can even go on exchange even without a TC. It really depends on how safe or secure you feel about your odds of getting a TC. The idea of dean's list. So if you look at the SMU law dean's list, it usually gets longer and longer and longer over the years. So in year one, the dean's list very short. Year two, maybe still quite short, but year three will get longer and year four will get longer. The reason why is I feel that partly to do with competition and partly to do with people finally adapting to law and studying law. So in year one and two, as I mentioned, everyone takes core modules. Essentially, the whole cohort is taking the same module, so competition is much tougher, it's harder for you to get an A. And also, at the start, people tend to not know how to strategize or how to even study for law, so their grades might not be so good. But once you hit about year two, you start to get a hang of it, you start to know your studying routine, your grades might improve. But largely, it is due to this option that comes in. Essentially, when you can choose your electives, you can choose what you're good at, the kind of mods that you're good at. Some mods are more like essay-based, some mods are more hypo-based, some mods are more like math and science-based, some are more linguistics-based, like if you do jurisprudence, yeah, I think it's a bit more artistic to me, at least. But if you do like economics analysis of law, it is more math and science-based. So you can play to your strengths in your choice. And also, you have to do some of the school core modules, which are non-law modules. Typically, they should be quite easy to score in. So there are people who try to inflate their grades by taking modules from other faculty that are easier to score in to pull up their grades. I don't really advise you to do that because these modules can be pretty irrelevant. But if you really want to score well, you really want to be on the dean's list and you want a grade so badly, you can go ahead and take another module and take more workload. But just be wise about it. And also just take note that to be on the dean's list, you have to get a minimum of 3.7 consecutive for both SEM 1 and SEM 2 in a year. So if there is one SEM that you go on exchange, it just means that year you will definitely not be on the dean's list because you don't have two SEMs in that one year. And I think it is regardless of whether both SEMs you get 3.7, like you get a 3.9 and a 3.6, then you average it out, as long as it's 3.7, you get the dean's list. Another thing I didn't put on here to consider is you can win subject prizes. I don't know what's the strategy to winning these subject prizes. Just be brilliant in the subject that you do. If you're really into winning these prizes, choose the electives that nobody really wants to do. So then my sharing gave you a roadmap of SMU law and what to expect so that you can make better plans and also better strategize in terms of your studies. That's all. Bye.